the purpose of this video is. We know that Tim Taranto's now been locked away from GWS. So we're going to have a look at the GWS situation, because obviously Cornelio is, he's not signed yet. You know, Lockie Whitfield's going to come into this conversation. So, I mean, are we looking at players that we could maybe have a look at, or are we just having a look at the GWS sort of side in general?
Yeah, well, I'm a man of logic and reason with maths, yep. And I'm just, this is my rumour with nothing. Cornelio is coming, and this is the proof, because this is logic. There's no, I've not heard this, I haven't got a source, this is just logic.
He's got to be, hey, it's like we said last week, mate, there's Italians, yeah, mate. Bring him in.
And this is
on street.
And this is why, we look at, these are the key players, so they've got seven young players, there's Haley as well, we haven't included them in the list.
Yep.
Because they won't be on big money. But these are their key players that are up for contract this year, next year, and Josh Kelly being the big one the year after. So these guys need to be tied down to contracts.
At some point.
So for me, what this is saying to me is you can't have all the eggs.
Yes.
And we look at some key names here. Jeremy Cameron, he's another one, 2020 next year. There's no way they're going to let him go. There's no way they're going to let Lockie Whitfield go, because they haven't got replacements for these.
So Whitfield and Cameron out of contract.
And you've got to think, they're young players coming through, Hartley, Hill. These are players that you could replace midfielders with. You can't replace skills like this. And they've got a lot of Cornelios, a lot of Whitfields.
Interesting.
But they can't lose them all. So if we look down the list, you see there, Daniel Lloyd, another key performer. Didelio this year. They're going to re-sign him. I think he's been very good for them.
Yeah.
Then you go down the list. Zachary Williams, being probably one of the best halfback flanks in the comp.
Yep.
Matt DeBoer, who's been their best tagger.
Yeah.
And obviously the big one at the bottom, Josh Kelly. And I've also forgotten Finlayson. How good's he been?
Yes.
So all these players have to be re-signed.
Yep.
And it was anticipated at the start of the year that they could only sign two of three of Cornelio, Whitfield and Kelly.
Okay.
Well, one they never talked about was Taranto. We know he's got a very substantial offer. His agent has said they met the terms. So we can predict that that's about 700k. So I'm saying, categorically, one of them will be available.
Will be available. Interesting. So if it's not Cornelio this year, could be Whitfield next year.
Yeah, it'll be Cornelio.
You think the
Cog is here?
Cog is coming to Carlton.
He's in my mind. I'll be the brokenest man in the world if he doesn't. But logic would say I would be trading this year, not next.
Okay.
Because I think next year they're going to have a handful on their hands with Cameron, Finlayson, and Whitfield.
And
every
Whitfield.
Club. So to me, if I was the list manager, I'd be like, let's get the money we need and end this. Because next year, they don't want people throwing contracts at them players.
Interesting. Well, there it is there. We've gone a little bit deeper from last week as to who's available at the GWS Giants. What do you think? Are you still on the Coggy train like Dan? Or do you think we should wait for a Whitfield next year? Or do you just think that we don't need any of these GWS players? Do you think that we're done and we've got the list that we need and we should look elsewhere? Let us know in the comments below. I think this is going to be a conversation that just continues to bubble until we get the signatures.